Scorpio, welcome back, y'all. We're gonna go ahead and get your reading started. No long intro, we just gonna jump into it. What's going on for Scorpio next 72? Next 48. Why? I'm sorry, y'all. Next 48, not next 72. Whew. Adjudication in reverse. All right. Some of y'all are ready to move forward in the next 48 hours. You want to do something new. Some of y'all, you have something in your life that you really feel is like your anchor, something that really holds you down or makes you feel like you can make it. You may have a lot of situations in your life that tries to weigh you down, but it's like you have this one thing where it's like, nah, you ain't going down. I'm finna get lifted right back up. I'm finna get lifted right the fuck back up. So some of y'all are clinging on to that or holding on to that. That one thing. It could be a thing. It could be a person. It could be a place. Like, some of y'all are really holding close to something in the next 48 hours. You could receive some type of message, or you could be trying to message someone. Some of y'all are just ready to go down a new, different path in your life. You're like, I'm ready to start things over. I'm ready to get things together for me, go towards something that makes me happy. Some of y'all could be going somewhere in the next 48. Some of y'all may be packing up or leaving somewhere. He got a lot of bags here, so some of y'all could be leaving somewhere in the next 48. Some of y'all could be waiting on somebody to like pick you up. Clarify this. Some of y'all are trying to be patient. You like, I'm being patient, but I don't want to have to wait on a situation. You're like, I don't want to have to wait on this, but I'm being patient because you're ready to wrap up some type of cycle in your life. You're like, I've been dealing with a lot of weird motherfuckers, so now it's time for me to let that shit go and wait on what it is that I truly want. Clarify adjudication. You don't want anybody to judge you. You feel like you're ready to have good things happen in your life, and you like, I don't want to hear nobody fucking mouth about it. I don't want to hear what nobody got to say because I want to do something that makes me happy. For real, for real. You like, I feel like this is my life, my luck. It's time for me to figure some things out, rediscover who I am. I got good memories, I got bad memories, but at the end of the day, I just want to move forward. You like, I don't want to hear nobody's opinion, nobody's mouth. Clarify message. Yeah, y'all are ready. Y'all tired of waiting on something. Clarify that. Some of y'all, somebody maybe wanted to message you about maybe going to like a burial grounds with them. This could be the anniversary of somebody's death or somebody's passing. Somebody may be reaching out to you to let you know that they want you to go with them to this place, to this burial grounds or something. That's not for everybody though. This could be somebody that you was in a relationship with. For some of y'all, they may be trying to reach out to you or message you because you ended things with them. For some of y'all, this could just simply be an ending. Like you could be reaching out to somebody, letting them know that you don't want them anymore or you don't want to deal with them anymore. We're going to look into that though. Whoever this person is, it's like you don't want to fight with them. You're not looking for this person. You're not mad at this person. You don't want revenge on this person. You just don't want nothing to do with it. But for some of y'all, you feel like this person is bitter. They bitter. They always nagging at you. And it's like they... It's like this person feel like if they fight with you, that must mean you connected to them in some type of way. Or you still want to deal with them in some type of way. And you like, no, you getting it twisted. I'm done people pleasing. I'm done trying to please you. You feel like something or somebody was a bad decision. Like, damn, I should have never dealt with you. Whoever this is, they don't really have like nothing to give you either. They don't have no money. They don't really have anything to give you. They don't even have enough to like go anywhere. For some of y'all. That I'm hearing they don't even have like gas money to come see you. Clarify pathway. Give me more on that. I got like a ex friend or an old friend that could be some of y'all getting away from a lot of people. You getting away from a friend too, or somebody that you used to be cool with. You feel like this person, they not loyal at all to you. You like, you disloyal as fuck. You don't do shit but give me bad fucking advice and bad news. Whoever this is, they real negative, and you like, I don't really want to be around you. Some of y'all, this person could be losing some type of home too. They could be losing a home, or they don't have any privacy in the home that they're in. But you don't, it's, that's not really your issue. You walking away from this person. Yeah, this friend need a ride from you. They need a ride, or they need some transportation or something like that. Some of y'all, this person could have lived out of town, or they could be trying to move out of town before or now. Somebody may be asking you for a ride to the airport. Because whoever their first ride was, it didn't work out. Or they not taking them no more. So they may be asking you. You could have been knowing this person for a long time. You and this person are not young no more. Some of y'all could have went to school with this person. But they did some shit that was unforgivable to you. Some of y'all, you figured out what this person had going on. They did some shady shit to you behind your back. And you wanted to stop fucking with them then. Yeah, you knew this situation with this person wasn't going nowhere. But you felt like they kept trying to be around you, or they kept trying to kick it with you. Yeah. Okay. So, clarify journey. Scorpio, y'all like, I don't want no trouble. I don't want no trouble. For real. You like, I ain't come here for all that. I ain't come here for no fight. I ain't come here for no attitude. I ain't come here for no issues, no problem, no drama. Give me more on that. Some of y'all need a ride. Or you need like, not to say you need to blow off some steam, but it's like some of y'all need some space. You need to get away from other people. Some of y'all feel like you don't have anything to do outside of hanging with other individuals. Like, you feel like you need like a hobby or something to do when you alone. You don't want to be around other people right now because you feel like people don't do nothing but cause you problems or argue with you and fight with you. And you like, I don't want that. Why would I want to be around people that don't show me no affection or don't show me no love? Yeah, you don't feel protected hanging around the people that you surround yourself with. So it's like you choosing to jig by yourself. Some of y'all not even responding to like DMs and shit. Yeah, you trying to make wiser choices. You trying to choose like happiness over history, because some of y'all figuring out that the people that you had history with or the people that you've been dealing with for a long time, you like, you don't really fuck with me like you say you do. A lot of the people that you surround yourself with, they like to throw shade towards you or be funny with you, try to make you feel like you useless or try to make you feel like you don't have enough or that like you not enough. So you choosing to release a lot of people and let them go. Some of y'all looking for change in your life. Oh, that's because y'all attracted to somebody. What the hell? Okay, so that was the last card. Okay, give me one more on that. That was in a decade when he's supposed to be in. Give me something on that. Scorpio, y'all being slick. Y'all got somebody that y'all attracted to, and that's why. That's why. Some of y'all are making a lot of decisions for yourself. It's like you putting your big boy or big girl boots on and you like, fuck this shit. I'm finna go ahead and be happy and do shit for me. I done pleased a lot of people my whole life and sacrificed my happiness, but now I'm not doing that no more. Some of y'all are ready to flirt with somebody that you find attractive, sexy. You want to resurrect the relationship, something that could possibly be over right now. Let me see some, y'all. Yeah. Okay, let's see, Scorpio. Okay. It's my song. Okay. Give me something more for Scorpio next 48. I don't know if this came. I'm gonna take it upright. Something y'all end in a relationship quick. You end in something. And you doing it fast. You got your guard up. It's like you... Some of y'all could be blocking somebody or something like that. But you putting your guard up and you doing it quick. You don't want to be with somebody or you don't want to live with somebody. Clarify four of wands in reverse. Oh, never mind. Somebody mad at you because they feel like you don't want to be with them. Somebody angry. They could be violent as fuck, too. You could be a father or you can have kids with whoever this person is. Some of y'all could have lived with this person before, but... Yeah, you done waiting on that situation. Why is Ace of Clubs here? You're trying to figure out a way to do something, but you feel like you blocked in a way, like you can't get to it directly. Yeah, some of y'all want to give somebody another opportunity. You feel like this person is very innocent. You feel like they're a very loving person. Like they give you the shirt off their back type shit. Some of y'all are ready to have some type of rebirth or a new beginning with someone else. A new beginning in love. Y'all got a new beginning in love coming for y'all, Scorpio. But you just don't know how to get it. You feel like you don't have what you need to manifest a situation or to manifest a person into your life or to bring this person back. You stuck on how to do that. You feel like it's a lot of miscommunication between you and somebody else, and it's like you want to fix that. But you don't feel like it's working out in your favor. You feel like it's going bad or it's just all bad. Lots of justice in reverse. Somebody getting some badass karma too. Somebody is going through a whole lot of shit. Scorpio, if you notice that, say if you start praying for the people who don't have your best interest at heart to be revealed towards you or to be revealed and removed from your life, God gonna start showing you the exact people that's really trying to fuck you over or the exact people that's really wishing bad on you in your life. If somebody come around you and they be like, damn, Scorpio, all this shit just happened to me. I'm getting evicted. My lights off. Shit, my motherfucking pinky toe fell off. My elbow hurt. I ain't got skin on my right arm no more. Everybody. You know, not saying that that's exactly what's going on with these people. But anybody that come to you and tell you shit like that or tell you all the bad shit that's happening to them. And you've been praying for God to reveal and remove people from your life. Start paying attention to those very people that's complaining to you about the things that they're going through. Because a lot of times, the people that's going through the worst shit be the ones that was wishing bad on you. Y'all better start keeping yourselves protected. Literally, protect yourself. Y'all could literally have somebody up, stuck in their head. They can't sleep. Why is that? because they know you're done with them. Whoever this person is, they know you're done taking a leap of faith on this situation. Could be a Libra. This person feel like it's a done deal. It's over. Yeah, a lot of y'all getting ready to call judgment in your own life. As a matter of fact, this ain't even... Yeah, I don't mean to preach or nothing like that, but here's the thing. Have y'all ever been forced out of a situation? It's like you keep trying with a situation, or you keep trying, you keep fighting for it. And it's like no matter what you do, it's never good enough. It keeps failing. It's always broken down. It's because that person is being forced out of your life. Even if it comes to you being in a certain place that you ain't supposed to be in. If you are not supposed to be at a certain place, you are going to get signs that you don't need to be where you are at that exact moment. And when you get them signs and them intuitive nudges, you need to listen to that. Listen to your intuition, because if you don't, that's when shit starts happening bad and affecting you. Sometimes it don't even be your karma that you're receiving. Sometimes y'all picking up other people's karma. Or you picking up karma because you're not supposed to keep yourself attached to a certain situation. When God wants somebody out of your life, or when they want a situation to end, then that's exactly what's going to be forced to happen. So it's like, if you do it on your own, you in good hands. But if God had to do it for you, force a person, place, or thing out of your life, he not doing it pleasantly. He not doing that shit to work to the point where you going to like it. You going to lose a few things. Your feelings may be hurt. It's going to be a lot of shit that feels like, damn, I really had to go through this. And the answer is yes. If it's a lesson that's trying to be instilled to you, or that's trying to be given to you or guided to you, and you don't follow them intuitive nudges, the after effects after that shit really hurts, you know? But what I'm saying is to say, if you are in a situation that you're getting yourself out of, or you finally making a decision to leave it behind on your own, then that's wonderful. You know, that means it ain't no damage. Nobody karma can follow you. Nobody karma can touch you. That's what I mean by protect yourself. So I don't know how y'all had to end a situation, but somebody ain't sleeping right because of it. And it's this other person. Yeah, some of y'all have a brand new opportunity that's presenting itself to you in your life. But some of y'all, this could be a financial opportunity that's presenting itself to you. You could have a new job that's reaching out to you, telling you that you are hired. But a lot of y'all, this could be a new relationship or a new connection that's coming in for you. You getting ready to invest in somebody. Whoever this person is, you could feel like they're very cold towards you right now. Some of y'all may feel like this person is cold towards you, or they don't show you no affection. Why is a death card here? Whoever this person is, ever since you ended things with this person, or ever since things ended, you have had a hard time moving on from this situation. You walked away from this situation disappointed. Whatever you walked away from, it's like, damn, I really can't see this person, or I really can't deal with this person. Can I find a chariot in reverse? Some of y'all are just choosing to be single because you feel like you scared to go towards somebody because you feel like you wasn't the best to this person, or you didn't treat them right. Maybe you was unreliable when it came to them, or they could have been that way towards you. But for some of y'all, this is your energy. You may feel like you either cheated on this person or didn't really treat them the best. So you scared to go towards them. Okay. Some of y'all trying to avoid a disaster, but you really want to talk to somebody. You really want to commit to this person or be in a relationship with somebody from your past. You want to tell this person how much you care about them. But you could have chose somebody that you felt was something that you didn't need or want. Whoever this person is, you feel like they have a lot of emotions for you. They really care about you. They really love you. But you could have been hiding a lot of things from this person. You could have been on your player shit at the time. Now y'all want to reach out to this person and make things work, but you feel like it's too much drama, or you feel like it's going to cause a lot of drama if you do that. Okay. We got a lot of earth energy out here. It could be some of y'all could be connecting with a Taurus, a Virgo, or a Capricorn. A Leo. A Cancer. A Aries. A Scorpio may be reaching out to you. Or a Libra may be reaching out to you. Okay. How do you feel about this? Or Pisces. Yeah, my bad. We got Pisces out here too. So how do you feel about this person that you're trying to go towards? You feel like you and this person that you're trying to go towards are destined to be together? This came out in Capricorn reading too. So yeah, some of y'all, you feel like you're meant to be with whoever this person is that you're trying to go towards. That's the mutual energy. The mutual energy between you and this person is less play. So you missing this person's energy. You want to go out and have a good time with them. They may want to do the same with you. Some of y'all, they really want to, they like playing with you. Some of y'all, this is, you and this person are playful together. They miss that energy and you do too. This person does love you, Scorpio. They refuse to reach out to you though. But they do want to have a conversation with you. So it's like they refuse to reach out, but they want to talk to you. And they want to be honest with you. They want to be honest with you, or they want honesty from you. Okay. Yeah, this person feels like y'all connection is too, it's really intense. Y'all gonna get engaged, yeah, or you can already be engaged to somebody to get married, but others of y'all could be getting engaged. Congratulations. Or you could just be getting into a relationship in the next 48, but you have somebody that's chasing you that you don't really have any passion for. So whoever this person is that's chasing you, they want to work things out with you, or they want to get you, and it's like you don't, you feel like that's a negative situation. You don't want to manifest it because you feel like this person doesn't give you what you need. And y'all done dealing with different options. You like, I'm done dealing with different people. I'm done dealing with you and you. If you ain't the one, I don't need you. Yeah, some of y'all just want to get married. You ready to settle down or just find somebody that is like the one for you. So you ending things in your life. Yeah, you done taking chances and meeting up with people that you feel it ain't gonna work with. And you giving clarity to these people in these situations. You like, I don't think this gonna work out. I can't kick it with you. I can't meet up with you. I can't hang with you. None of that. So that's good. Y'all giving people the truth. Letting people know that it's time to break up, or letting people know that it's a wrap for you. Let's get the advice for y'all, and then we gonna wrap it up. Okay, what's the advice for Scorpio? Scorpio, you have to stop doubting yourself. Some of y'all are so ashamed of past mistakes or past situations that you are not allowing yourself to be happy. It's like you hiding how you truly feel, and you hiding what it is that you truly want. You can't do that. If you want to be in a situation, you have to think the best about a situation. You have to feel that you are worthy or that you deserve a situation. Some of y'all, you have to learn and know your worth. Not saying that y'all don't already know y'all worth, but it's like you got to start allowing people to pour into your cup. You cannot punish yourself for life. Or you can't blame yourself for life for the things that other people do to you. And you can't blame yourself. Well, you just got to chill out, y'all. Some of y'all doubt yourself a lot, and you cannot do that if you want better for you. You feel, well, that's shame here with giving and receiving in reverse. Some of y'all finally adapting to change in your life. You like, I can't give to the people that don't give to me. And that's how you should be, Scorpio. That's how you should be. You don't work hard to please people that don't care about pleasing you. You don't work hard to please people that have bad agendas or bad intentions when it comes to you, and you can't feel bad for it. Because here's the thing you gotta learn: when people make their own bed, they gotta lay in that shit. You don't get people second and third chances to play with you. Ground your emotions, and once your emotions are grounded, you need to stop allowing people to come into that door. Once you are at peace, once you are living in your truth, once you have your true feelings out there and you say how you feel, what it is going to be and what it ain't going to be, you need to start closing doors to old chapters, y'all. You cannot keep reopening these doors when you are in your element or when you are at a peaceful stage in your life. Because one thing the past do, it disrupts your future. Certain things from your past will fuck with your future. You have to start closing doors, and you need to allow those doors to stay shut if you want to be in something that makes you feel happy. Yeah, you cannot try to manifest something new while keeping old things attached in your life. If y'all in a peaceful state right now, you feel like it's a peaceful time in your life, then that's what you need to continue working on. Some of y'all, it's time for y'all to put yourself in a position to deal with people that are good for you. People that are like family to you. People that feel like love to you. It's time for y'all to align yourself with them type of things, because y'all are meant to have the life that you want. But in order for you to get that, you have to be the one to do the work, put the work in. Stop allowing people to betray you. Stop allowing people to stomp on you or stab you in the back and then allowing them back into your life. You ain't got to get mad at people. You just need to resist dealing with people. Don't get mad. Don't get even. Get ghost. I'm just saying, don't get mad. Don't get even. Just chunk up the deuces and say, fuck a motherfucker. Fuck a person. Bye. That's what I got for y'all though, Scorpio. Number 20 could be important. Number 13. Number 19. Some of y'all could be 41 years old. September could be important. March, the number 18. But that's what I got for y'all, Scorpio. Thanks for watching, y'all. Like, share, subscribe. And also, y'all, tell a friend of a friend. The New Kid on the Block Tarot did your reading. Send they ass to my channel, y'all. Bye.